So, good morning, everybody. And it's if on cue, we have somebody at the door, which means that it seems like quite a few months since I was last at study, and probably a good 6 months ago now, probably since we moved into the hall. But this morning, since we have pre-recorded worship by Major Lisa Lloyd, our divisional leaders, I thought we could do that from home this morning. So we are just popping on, as we normally do before worship, to give a shout out to those who are watching. So some of you have already put your name and where you're watching from in the comments on Facebook and YouTube, or in the chat on sermon.net, and you've still got a few moments to do that, and I will try and pick them up and give you a shout out this morning. So let's have a look, and we will go over to our Facebook page first. I notice that there's already quite a few people who've already said. Laura, we have Malcolm, who's joined us from cloudy Western Supermega. I think that's what it's like around this side of the country. Karen and Alastair from Basingstoke have come on and said looking forward to sharing worship with us, as I'm sure we all are. Dorothy says morning from sunny Dunstable. So I think we're beginning to see which side of the country has got the sun this morning. So I hope you're enjoying that while you can. Nikki and Tony from Basingstoke have just joined and said good morning. Good morning to you both. John Baskerville from Hensford has joined us. Good to see you again, John. And Lorraine says good morning to my army family. And that's how we want you to feel this morning, whether you have ever been to Basingstoke in person, or whether you've only ever joined us online, we hope that you feel part of our family this morning. We also have Angus, who's joined us again from South Wales. Good to see you this morning, Angus. And Clive has joined us from the Isle of Wight. Clive sent me a really interesting letter this week from International Headquarters, dated 1976, I think it was, to say thank you to him and his colleague after completing the building work at our Salvation Army Hall, which is now not our Salvation Army Hall because it was replaced in 2007. But it was good to see that letter this week. Thank you for sending that to me, Clive. Let's go over to, we'll go over to my Facebook page, because I know that at least two people have logged on there yet. So Robert and Shirley from Cradley Heath are saying hello there. So hello to you two. And we will go over now to YouTube. All a bit slow on YouTube this morning. I don't know if the YouTube watchers are either having difficulty. I know there's one or two who normally watch on YouTube that seem to be watching on Facebook this morning. But Nyasha, who's joined us for over the last few months, is with us. So good to see you there. If there's anybody else there and you want to say hello, then you've got a few moments to do that before I head back to the music so that we can prepare our hearts and our minds for worship. Let's go over to sermon.net and check who's checking in on there. We've got quite a few that have come up since I last looked. So Stuart and Linda say hello from Basingstoke. I was going over Linda's name because I was trying to read at the same time the fact that Stu enjoyed listening to the hymn tune arrangement French as a good start to Sunday morning. Yeah, I like that one as well, especially for the finale. Roy and Elaine say hello to everybody, including Harley. Yes, fortunately Harley's quieting down now, so that's good. Will and Pauline say good morning from Basingstoke. Good to see you as well. And Alan, Yvonne and Bethany from Basingstoke have just joined and said good morning and said praise the Lord, my soul, for he is good. I hope that that's what you can say in your soul this morning, whatever sort of week you've had, that he is good. And so we can praise him as we come together in worship this morning. One more check around the platforms and make sure that we haven't missed anyone, hopefully. And then we will go head back to the pre-worship music. So we're back on Facebook, which I can't now get to open up. So let's just do a refresh on that and see if that helps. Oh, there we go. That's better. And we've got a few more. I must have a proper look down the list to make sure. Yeah, Wendy Taylor says good morning. Good to see you again, Wendy. You've joined us for the last few months. And Brenda Hall from a sunny but white Washington, and that's Washington Tynan, we're not Washington DC. So there seems to have been quite a bit of snow up north over these last few days. So hope you're keeping safe and warm. And Marilyn says hello. Marilyn's just joined us from Basingstoke as well. Good to see you this morning with an exclamation mark, which I suspect means she's super excited that she's managed to put a hello in this week before we shut down and went back to the music. So good to see you this morning, Marilyn. Let's go back over to this page and make sure we've picked up everybody there. Yep, and we'll go over to YouTube, see if anybody's woken up on YouTube now. No, we're still just with Nyasha. Nyasha, well done for keeping up the YouTube end this morning. And we'll do one more sweep of sermon.net. And then, and Daphne's just joined us from North Walsham in North Norfolk. So good to see you this morning, Daphne. So welcome, whether you've said hello in the comments or chat or not, welcome along to worship with Basingstoke Salvation Army. We hope that you are challenged and equipped by the message that you hear today. Worship is led by our Divisional Leader for Leader Development, Major Lisa Lloyd-Jones, and I look forward to joining worship with you. For anybody who's worried about whether I can be in two places at the same time, joining in worship with you and doing the Holiness Hour on Fortress Radio, you'll be pleased to know that the Fortress Radio broadcast is pre-recorded. So I'm not abandoning you this morning. The only thing I abandoned for the Fortress Radio broadcast was an evening watching rubbishy telly, which is probably good for all of us. So I look forward to joining worship with you and listening to the message that God has given Major Lisa this morning. And I look forward to seeing you again soon. God bless you all.
Good morning, everyone. Here are the announcements. Immediately after this service, you're invited to join us for coffee fellowship on Zoom on the normal meeting number, and all are invited. 3:30 this afternoon, Sunday school again on Zoom on the normal meeting number. This evening's youth fellowship at 8:00 again on Zoom on its normal number is a quiz night, and everyone is invited. Wednesday morning, coffee stop again on Zoom and again on the normal meeting number. And on Wednesday evening at 7:30, there is the opportunity to participate in film fellowship via Zoom, and it's the next in the series of the Marching As to War series, episode 6. That's at 7:30 on Wednesday evening. And on Thursday evening at 6:45, there's an opportunity for those who are so inclined to participate in a Tai Chi gentle exercise class. The Zoom number is on the screen and the password. However, we do ask that if you are going to take part, it would be great to let Marie know. And Marie's phone number is in the grapevine. Next Sunday, our worship will be online, and it is the launch of our self-denial missionary appeal. The theme of the meeting will be self-denial, giving from the heart, based on the second book of Corinthians chapter 9. And it will be available on the normal three platforms of sermon.net, Facebook and YouTube. After that, normal opportunity to join in our regular activities of coffee fellowship at 12:15 or thereabouts, 3:30 Sunday school and youth fellowship, this time limited to those over the age of 17, at 8:00. Some prayer requests. We continue to ask your prayers for Trevor and the family as they mourn the loss of Fred. For Brian Sharp, who is still in hospital, and all the family who are concerned and caring for him at this time. And Tony Blythe's dad, Bernard Blythe, is settling into his care home, but he has a few health problems. And we ask for your prayers at this time, and indeed for all of our wider core family, as we continue to strive to manage the situation we all find ourselves in during this pandemic. May God bless you.
Good morning, my name is Lisa Lloyd-Jones and I'm a divisional leader here in Central South. It's been a while since we've been here now, and yet we've still not managed to meet you face to face. We really hope and pray and believe that the days are coming when we can come back and actually worship in person together and gather in God's name to sing praises and worship him. I don't know what's made you press play on the recording this morning. Maybe you do this out of habit on a Sunday morning. Maybe you just want to zoom in and see what things look like, and we'll soon be moving on to another platform to see something else. Maybe, and I really pray, that you have pressed play because you want to hear God's voice. When we worship together, when we sing our praises, when we pray and open God's word, it is all with the sole intention of hearing God speak. Because that's what his scriptures are there for, to teach and to guide and to encourage. And my theme this morning throughout our worship together is exactly that. What is God saying to you? How is he speaking? How is he calling you to come closer to him? And so we start with a song that's very familiar to all of us. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. I draw your attention to three verses that have lines relevant to all of us today. In verse 2, we are encouraged to ponder anew what the Almighty can do. My goodness, that's a prayer for us all to make. And in verse 3, we're reminded of the tempests when warfares are raging round us. And then finally, in that last verse, I hope you will lift your voice. Let the Amen sound from his people again. Let's have a good sing in our homes and start to connect with God in our worship this morning. Amen. And so we continue in sung worship with a more contemporary song, a song that's become very special to all of us over the recent years. Bless the Lord, O my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, O my Lord. And the verse is very simply, whatever may pass, whatever lies before me, may I be singing when the Spirit calls. So let's enjoy, let's start to connect with God and make this prayer our own this morning before we read from Psalm 46 together.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never. Worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before, time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then your worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never.
Share with you as an introduction to worship from Psalm 46. If you've got your scriptures or your tablets and your tools on board, then have a look at it, and there'll be little bits of it, I'm sure, that you just want to circle and highlight to speak to you today. Psalm 46, verse 1. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come and see the works of the Lord, the desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God.
Come to our world, to our world.
Will you join me in prayer? Father God, in these moments, we recognise our need for you in our world. Never before have we seen every element of our world affected in the same theme of this pandemic and the devastation that is coming in so many different places. We're reminded through the Psalms that whilst nations are crumbling and kingdoms are falling amidst all kinds of challenges, you are our ever-present help in a time of struggle. We've just heard the music come into our world. And that's a prayer that we make today. Come into my own world, my personal world, my family, my loneliness, my isolation, my fear and my anxiety. Come into my world. Come into my world at church, in our communities, to those that are suffering, grieving and struggling, to those that are celebrating and yet not able to share with others. Come into our world. And for our country and its leaders, and for our world and all that that challenge unfolds, come into our world. Lord, there's so many times when we can do so little. There's such a small difference that we can make. And yet in doing so, we are trying our best to seek you. And our prayer for this time of worship together is that you will speak and we will recognise your voice. So hear our prayer. Speak to our hearts today, Lord. Amen. When we open scripture together in a few moments, we will see that actually God has been speaking from the beginning. We look at the creation story and we realise perhaps it was the first thought on your mind and God said, let there be light, let there be day, let there be night. And so I've asked Vanessa at Buckingham in her family church to open the scripture to us, and maybe this is something that you can look at as a family. It'll be followed by a song that's awfully catchy and quite annoying, but it comes back to the point every day. God speaks and God says. Enjoy these moments of scripture and of a song together.
Hello, I'm Vanessa. I'm going to share a story with you from the Jesus Storybook Bible about creation and God's beginning of our world. It's called The Beginning, A Perfect Home. In the beginning, there was nothing. Nothing to hear, nothing to feel, nothing to see. Only emptiness and darkness and nothing but nothing. But God was there and God had a wonderful plan. I'll take this emptiness, God said, and I'll fill it up. Out of the darkness, I'm going to make light. And out of the nothing, I'm going to make everything. Like a mummy bird flutters her wings over her eggs to help her babies hatch, God hovered over the deep, silent darkness. He was making life happen. God spoke, that's all. And whatever he said, it happened. God said, hello, light, and light shone into the darkness. God called the light day and the darkness night. You're good, God said, and they were. Then God said, hello, sea, hello, sky, and a great space opened up wide and deep and high. You're good, God said, and they were. Then God said, hello, land. And there, splashing up through the oceans, came cliffs, mountains, sandy beaches. You're good, God said, and they were. Hello, trees, God said. Hello, grass and flowers, and everything, everywhere, burst into life. He made buds bud, shoot, shoot, flowers flower. You're good, God said, and they were. Hello, stars, God said. Hello, sun, hello, moon, and whizzing into the darkness came fiery globes, spinning around and around, whirling orange and purple and golden planets. You're good, God said, and they were. Hello, birds, God said, and with a fluttering and flapping and chirping and singing, birds filled the skies. Hello, fish, God said, and with a darting and dashing and wriggling and splashing, fish filled the seas. You're good, God said, and they were. Then God said, hello, animals, and everyone came out to play. The earth was filled with noisy noises, growling and gobbling and snapping and snorting and happy scuffling. You're good, God said, and they were. God saw all that he had made, and he loved them, and they were lovely because he loved them. But God saved the best till last. From the beginning, God had a shining dream in his heart. He would make people to share his forever happiness. They would be his children, and the world would be their perfect home. So God breathed life into Adam and Eve. When they opened their eyes, the first thing they ever saw was God's face. And when God saw them, he was like a new dad. You look like me, he said. You're the most beautiful thing I've ever made. God loved them with all of his heart, and they were lovely because he loved them. And Adam and Eve joined in the song of the stars and the streams and the wind in the trees, the wonderful song of love to the one who made them. Their hearts were filled with happiness, and nothing ever made them sad or lonely or sick or afraid. God looked at everything he had made. Perfect, he said, and it was. But all the stars and the mountains and oceans and galaxies and everything were nothing compared to how much God loved his children. He would move heaven and earth to be near them, always. Whatever happened, whatever it cost him, he would always love them. And so it was that the wonderful love story began.
And God said the sun should shine, the rain should fall, the flowers should grow. And God said the birds should sing, and it was so. And God said the grass should grow, the trees bear fruit, the wind should blow. And God said the stream should flow, and it was so. And God said the sun should shine, the rain should fall, the flowers should grow. And God said the birds should sing, and it was so. And God said the grass should grow, the trees bear fruit, the wind should blow. And God said the stream should flow, and it was so. And it was so.
I hope you enjoyed the reminder of the creation story, and also that song that for me has lived in my head, and it's been one of those thoughts that has just kept coming back, and it reminds us of how God speaks. We're going to listen to Territorial Envoy Roger Coates. He's at Reading Lower Early with his wife, Lieutenant Jacqueline Coates. He speaks very openly about how God spoke to him, what God said, and how he responded. It's been my privilege over the last 25 years to listen to people sharing their story of how God has spoken to them. And I hope today, as we share these moments, that you maybe need to think, how is God speaking to me? And what is he saying? Listen to Roger and see if it matches with your story, and hear God speak today. And then we're going to sing together. What a faithful God have I. Over all those years of God speaking and us putting it to the back of our mind, he remains faithful, and we continue to worship him with that song together.
Vision and Commitment Sunday changed my life. I'd had various roles of senior leadership in various corps throughout the Salvation Army. And here I was, January 2015, Vision and Commitment Sunday, and it was a turning point for me. I was involved at the Corps in the band. I held a role at divisional level looking after the youth chorus, but I clearly felt on that particular Sunday that God wanted more from me. More in terms of my place in the Corps. I didn't know what exactly, but God did. I spoke to our officers and I shared what God had laid on my heart. And then that was it. The months ticked by, nothing seemed to be happening. I think God was possibly checking on my ability to trust him and to have patience. Towards the end of that summer, the October in fact, I was asked to take up a leadership role within that corps. Not one that I'd ever had before, let alone one that I even considered. It's a long story that followed, but that position clearly wasn't it as far as God was concerned. Far from it. In fact, it was only the start. The short version is that God used my time in that role and the experience that I went through to reveal to me a deeper calling to full-time ministry. And here I am, 6 years later, with my wife, leading Lower Early Corps, as we strive to serve the Corps and find our place where we can serve this beautiful community. It's crazy. Certainly in these times, as we continue to learn all the new ways required of us to be able to live out this calling and this covenant in these days. But God is good. And we are blessed to see his hand at work in the opportunities as we journey with folk. If you've never considered ministry as a local officer, as an officer, as a territorial envoy, as a pioneer, maybe now is the time to seek God's heart for his calling on your life. Please talk to your officers. Talk to the DHQ team. Drop me a message. I'd be more than happy. I'd be delighted, in fact, to share more of my story with you and to listen to what God might be saying to you. You've got nothing to lose, but everything to gain by stepping into his calling for your life. May God bless you.
One of the most exciting times for a family with a new family member and child is to hear their first words and first sounds. You spend time wondering what it's going to be. You expect it to be mummy or mum, 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 or dad, dad, dad. And actually, I think for my first child, at least, we ended up with Lala or Po because Teletubbies were very prime at the time. It could be for some of your family, it's been somebody from the In the Night Garden or Peppa Pig. And we wonder what their first names and sounds and words are going to be. Actually, it's not that relevant what they are. It's more important that they are speaking, they are communicating. They are able to do more than just cry to get your attention and the lines of communication start. We often joke now that we are parents of adults that we wish we'd never taught them to talk, because the debates and the discussions and the arguments and the dialogue that goes on can often be quite demanding and quite soul-searching. But we teach our youngsters to speak because we want them to communicate. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, right at the beginning, as Vanessa read for us earlier, we read the words, "And God said." God was speaking into the creation right from the beginning. His voice was making him real and his words were making an impact throughout time. Speaking is the first active verb of the universe. There can be no speech without a speaker. And here we see evidence of God's hand upon everything from the beginning. And maybe as you're sat at home looking out of your window now, it's light or it's dark, there's signs of new growth in the garden, you can hear the bird song and you can start to see how God was speaking to us and continues to speak to us through his creation. And because we have the blessing of a complete holy scripture that records the words of God, and with a little help from the internet, you can discover that whilst we might use Bible software to look how many times does it say, "And God said," actually he speaks throughout in so many different ways. When we open God's word, as we do when we come to worship and when we come to private devotions, we come to with an expectation that God is going to speak. I think we forget that. We think we're going to read, we think we're going to learn, but actually we do so in order to hear what God is saying to us. From Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, where God said, "Let there be light," we have a book of books called the Word of God. Even if God did not say something in it, His Holy Spirit inspired it to be written so that one day we might look at the words and hear God's voice. 2 Timothy 3 verse 16 says, "All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness." Every word of your scripture is God-breathed. It's God's voice. The amazing challenge that's left with us is to be in a place, a time, a mindset, a moment to be transformed because we realise we've heard God speak. I'm going to give you just a very few examples of what is revealed through the Bible of how God speaks to us. Firstly, God can speak through circumstances. God spoke to Jonah first with a voice. He called him, gave him a job to do, gave him a mission, gave him a service. And Jonah didn't heed God's voice. So God continued and spoke again to Jonah through circumstances. First being swallowed by a great fish, then the vine grew up to shade Jonah when he was spewed onto the land, and then the vine withered. All very extreme ways of getting Jonah to hear God's voice. God was using all kinds of situations and moments to speak to Jonah. The application we need to make is, how is God speaking to me in my circumstance? Perhaps less busy than normal, perhaps less in routine, perhaps less connected to God in the ways that we would normally connect, through music, through duty, through rehearsals, through service. And yet in every circumstance, I believe God can speak. We've heard answers to prayer of opportunities that have come along during this pandemic that we've never even expected to hear. And yet God has spoken and people have been obedient to obey. As with Jonah, our circumstances in the last year have been unexpected and unprecedented. I do still believe that God has been speaking, and when we choose to listen, it makes such a difference. The other way that I would say that God speaks is through dreams and visions. We see that in the scripture too. God spoke to Joseph, to Solomon, to Jacob, to Peter, John, and Paul in dreams and visions. We've recently been through a season of Advent, and if you look at Matthew 1 verse 20, you will read that an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said to Joseph, "Do not be afraid to take Mary home to be your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit." Again, God spoke to Joseph, this time through an angel in a dream, Matthew 2 verse 13, to warn him of a different direction for him, Mary, and Jesus. In Acts chapter 2 verse 17, Peter quotes Joel with these words, "In the last days," God says, "I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy, your young men will see visions, your old men will dream dreams." I wonder how many times something has come to you in the middle of the night, an idea, some inspiration, a reminder, a connection with somebody that you need to make. And so many times it's easy to just go back to sleep and next morning you're trying to remember what it was all about. It's even more annoying if you're a spiritual leader and you've had a great inspired thought in the night. Next morning, that sermon that was written in your dream has just gone. And I've learned over the years to scribble a few notes so that I've got it down on paper, because God is speaking. Sometimes he has to wait until we're in a dream. to give us a vision. And as we spend time in reflection, so important that we're making note of what God is saying to us. Of course, you need to be cautious and remember that everything needs to be tested through the power of the Holy Spirit. And sometimes it's when we test that vision and that vision that God has given us, we find out whether it is blessed or whether it's something that's just in our subconscious and needs discarding. I could give you an example, I'm not going to just now because time is passing, of when God gave me a vision of something I needed to step out in faith. And it was only because I did that all the other dots falled into place. And we saw a miracle come to fruition that I could never have done in my own strength. And so God speaks to us through his creation. He has been speaking from the beginning. He speaks through his word and he speaks through our dreams and visions. Finally, I want to say that God speaks to us, to people around us. And I want to read to you from 1 Samuel chapter 3. 1 Samuel chapter 3. The boy Samuel ministered before the Lord under Eli in those days. The word of the Lord was rare. There were not many visions. One night, Eli, whose eyes had become so weak that he could barely see, was lying down in his usual place. The lamp of God had not yet gone out. Samuel was lying down in the temple. Then the Lord called Samuel. Samuel, he answered, "Here I am." And he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." Eli said, "I did not call you. Go back and lie down." Again, the Lord called Samuel. And Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you did, you called me." "My son," Eli said, "I did not call you. Go back and lie down." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord. The word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel a third time. Samuel got up and went to Eli. He said, "Here I am, you called me." Eli realized that the Lord was calling the boy. So Eli told Samuel, "Go and lie down. If he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down. The Lord came and stood there calling, as at the other time, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel said, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." There's just a very few points there that I want to make. How faithful was Eli? But keep reminding Samuel, go and listen, go and respond, go and step out in faith. We thank God for the Elis of our world that have prompted all of us in our spiritual journey to respond. How about Samuel, a young boy, not very old at all, and yet still called by God? Let's never underestimate how God speaks to our children, how God speaks through children, and how they can then respond and grow into lives of service that are so divinely led. It puts us adults to shame. And let's just remember also that God, through that scripture, seemed to speak to Samuel before he was even a believer. And that's quite a thought-provoking idea to unpack. God is speaking to people before they even hear and recognise his voice. I hope today that your mind is open to listen to him, to follow him, and to see what he has to say to you. We're going to listen for a few moments to a band piece that's become very thought-provoking, and it's Prelude to Lavenham. And these are the words. The lyrics will come up on the screen, and I ask that you use the moments to respond. It just starts by saying, "Lord, there are times when I have to ask what? Times when your love is not easy to spot. What is life's purpose and what of me here? Grant me some answers, Lord. Make your will clear." I am always open to listen to anyone that wants to pick up the phone and say, I've heard God speak. As Roger said, we have our candidates officers around the division that can share that conversation with you. We also have one another, and that's what happened with Eli and Samuel. So I just pray now that you are listening to God and you are reflecting and responding to him. Let's pray together. Father God, your music has spoken to us. Your scripture has spoken to us. And your Holy Spirit continues to speak deep into our lives. So my prayer for my friends today is that they will hear you. They will listen, they will respond. They will be encouraged to look around them and see your voice and your call in every element of creation. that amidst the darkest of circumstances, they will take hold of an opportunity to hear you. And then as they consider deeper the dreams, the visions, the moments when God speaks to us directly by name, we will have the courage to respond. Lord bless us, and thank you for these moments of sharing together. Amen. Our closing song together is number 25 in the Salvation Army songbook. You'll have sung it for years and years, I promise you. But it does bring home, it brings to conclusion everything that we've shared together. God's love to me is wonderful. And it says in that second verse, my very steps are planned. When mists of doubt encompass me, I hold my Father's hand. His love has banished every fear. In freedom I rejoice, and with my quickened ears I hear the music of his voice. Have quickened ears to hear God speak to you today. Benediction prayer together from Paul's writing to the church at Thessalonica. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us and by his grace gave us eternal encouragement and good hope, encourage your hearts and strengthen you in every good deed and word. Amen. God bless you all.
See you. you wonder why we're joyful, why we're always full of song, and why we're far more happy than the longest days along? You marvel at the inward mirth our beaming faces show. Just listen to this little song. Sins of bygone years, the blood of many a score, went you see, never to be remembered anymore.
Never to be remembered. The sins are washed away. Oh, what peace and joy we've had since we began to pray with them. All the sins of bygone years, the blood of many a score, went you see, never to be remembered anymore.
Never to be remembered.